man siger, at det er for nylig. Nuns were sent on their way, and from the middle of the 19th century, it became home. And you know, you were all in that, probably in the cuckoo clock shop this morning. You know what kind of wood they use for the carving in the cuckoo clock? Exactly. They've got a lime wood in English. In America, you know, that's a lot of cuts. But that's not why we're here. We wanted to have a look at some interesting buildings. There's an interesting building across the road. Let's stay over here. We can look at it from here. It was built, you know, in 1609. Who do you think created that? Because that was the baron.
Barton.
Our friend Barton. He created the statue. You know what I got? It reminds me that it was originally Jean-Jacques Vatz is better known by his nickname Hans. Now Hans was a great French painter. He tells us what kind of a business. What do you think it was?
Butcher.
A butcher shop. A butcher shop. And notice what?
Une Alsacienne avec trois petits doigts. Et si vous regardez attentivement sur sa coiffe, eh bien vous verrez la cocarde bleue.
Balconies, you see the side shutters and the windows. This is a typical German house. We jump on house and look at the peach colour. This time, you see that front facade has been broken by those wrought iron balconies. No side shutters in the windows, lions come out with it. This is a typical French house. The one we have in the middle here, you see this one made balcony here. This is neither French nor German, it is in fact Italian. And to be more accurate, it's Tuscan. So there are three houses next to each other on one street and five of them. We're going to call them out with in that way. And the one there to the right of the French, is
there?
The he's a new coat of paint. Swan. It's the swan. It's a, you know, some people say, you know, stirring the bones. That is the fine example. Half-timbered houses, why do you think they call them half-timbered houses? Because they were half made of timber. They had a quarry stone foundation. The framework was made of timber. They used to fill in the gaps with rock and dirt, straw, clay, and bits of anything you could find. Half-timbered houses. But you know, the half-timbered houses, it was the poorer people who lived in these half-timbered houses. For anybody who actually wants to buy something, okay? Allow a pathway. That's not good. Let's have a look what they got here. First of all, these two jars. You can see the second jar there says choucroute. You know what choucroute means? Sauerkraut. But they wouldn't just put sauerkraut in there, they fill it up with potatoes, bacon, sausage, make a meal out of it. There's another jar to the next, to the side of it. It's called Beckeröfer. You know the housewives around here, they used to cook for their families every day of the week, apart from Monday. What happened on Monday? Laundry, washing day. Monday, washing day, no time to cook. What she used to do over the weekend, she'd cook more than was necessary. There'd always be something left over for the Monday.
Garlic.
Yorkshire, there you go.
you can tell me how much it costs.
Petit Thomas.
Now it's touching the ground. He has access to the road. How do you go to the airport? Let's hope he pays the bill. I don't know how much it costs. I don't know how much it costs. I've never been inside, but they tell me that it consists of two rooms. Altogether, they amount to 12 square yards. They enable the occupier, you know, to think you need to see who is fighting, who on a Saturday, who is going with who on a Friday, that can see themselves. Very popular. Bring the French.
I will get $2,000 rent in San Francisco.
The worst, the most horrible things of all are contained, is contained in these bottles. What do you think those bottles contain?
Beer.
Read between number two and number four. Well, what about number two? What about number two? What Noted once again the diamond pattern of the Habsburg building. It's built of yellow sandstone, interspersed with red sandstone, where it's been used in red egg and red egg. The Dominicans, you know, the Dominicans were a mendicant order. For them, poverty wasn't something to be ashamed of. It was an ideal to strive for. And if you entered this church originally, you'd find that it was very, very barely furnished, hardly anything there at all, just columns holding up the roof. And no pews to sit on, no seats to sit on. And some of those old services, you know, they'd go on for 3 hours, 3.5 hours. What language did the priest speak?
Latin.
Nobody understood it. 3.5 hours. Well, when I think about 3.5 hour services, it reminds me of my childhood. When I was a child, I had to go to chapel. Some of those services, they seemed to go on for 3.5 hours. No, you know, eventually, they found it in the south of France and damaged. And since 1975, it's been housed here in the Dominican Church. You can enter here, you can see it for €1.50. Really well worth a visit, and should you have the time and the inclination. Stop here, and we've come to another Hansi sign. And you see, this is the pretzel. The pretzel is not the palace that it is a bakery, still is a bakery. Boulangerie today, no overt political acts. You see the girl in the top, that's enough to tell us that it was a butcher shop originally. If you're not entirely convinced, look at the sausages around the side. There is no doubt that it was a butcher shop. It's no longer a butcher shop, but it used to be. It has a political message. You see the lion, a symbol of the Habsburgs, of the Germanics. And he is approaching from the right, from the east, in other words, with an axe in his hand. In other words, symbolizing the warmongering, aggressive Germans against the peaceful, civilized French. That's what. It's, well, this is one of my favorite parts. You must look at it. Look at the whole roll out. Look at the way it is. These postcards here are typical Hansi postcards. Hansi didn't just make those satirical signs. They also used to yes, it's true. It's a shop which sells ladies and gentlemen. But that's not why I'm standing here. Why am I standing here
today?
The date. The date of the 1379. I was wondering how she was. They began to be this house. 1379. Well over 600 years ago. We talked before about the vulnerability of these wooden houses. Well, obviously, if you looked up the house, there was no need for it to go up. Do you think that the houses that we're building these days will still be there in the year 2650? It's highly unlikely that they will happen. One thing is certain, we won't be there. So let's enjoy the city of Colmar this afternoon. Yeah, I'm sure you have absolutely no idea, ladies and gentlemen, of the. Through the centuries about these saints, and there's one main legend about St. Martin, the one which finds him while he was a member of the Roman Legion, which he later left because it didn't correspond with his Christian faith, but he was riding along on his horse, and he comes upon a beggar on the side of the road. He takes off his cape, and with his sword, he cuts the cape in half, gives a half to the beggar, retains the other half for himself. You might wonder why he didn't give the whole cape. Because for a week prior to St. Martin's, all the children in the kindergartens around here would be busy learning songs about St. Martin and making little lanterns for themselves. Because of the evening of St. Martin, he would form processions through the villages, towns, and cities around these parts of these different kindergartens. Nothing to do with Adolf Hitler, refers to the 19th century owner who uncovered some of those Gothic windows. Now then, it's regarded as the oldest house in Colmar. They believe it to have been built around 1350. But you can tell by looking at it that it wasn't all built at the same time. You look at the architecture, look at the windows. First of all, the ground floor there, you see those rounded arches? This is typical Romanesque architecture, which was prevalent here until the 13th century. And on the top, a half-timbered house.
Hello.
And one house, four different styles of architecture, one built after the other. Okay, we can cross the road to talk about the house to the right. He was told in the 17th century, also known as the Sewers. And it burnt up. At the same time, it burnt down its back. Also burnt down its back in 1570. It was rebuilt in 1570. It is interesting for us. It's another fine example of German castles.
Thank you.
These are scenes from Colmar, near the old car. Yep. Are there free restrooms over here?
Yeah, I remember he sent them to.
These are some pretty flowers.
We smell them, they're so aromatic.
Add a nice little This is surrounding a little canal here in Colmar.